It's hard to wake up when the shades have been pulled shut. This house is haunted, it's so pathetic, it makes no sense at all. I'm ripe with things to say, the words rot and fall away. A stupid poem could fix this home. Hey guys, this is going to be going up on the last day of June. Hope you had a happy Pride Month. If you're, you know, if you celebrate Pride Month. We're going to make our way down south. Oh, actually, use a calcium on Munchlax. Okay. Even though special attack is not what I'd want, it's good enough. Hello. Pokemon battles lure people in. Alright. So what we'll do is we're going to... Oh, shoot. I forgot to turn on the... Boom. I have to turn on the battle animations, but it's okay. It's just for this one fight. Oh my god. What was I saying? This is the last video of the month, for this game. And probably gonna be the last video for this game for a little while, because... I'm ready to go with Scarlet again. I'm ready to go with Brilliant Diamond again. I'm just gonna run out the episodes that I have of Ultra Sun. I'll keep doing that. Like, whenever there's a lapse in episodes of a game, what I'll just do is I'll take one of the games I had pre-recorded, upload all of those until they're all out. That way I can just get rid of them for right now. I'm still going to have to delete my entire playlist of Ultra Sun. Also, I didn't do it yet, but I'm going to redo the Ultra Sun intro because it didn't really match up very well. So yeah, what I'll do is I'm using the same song, because that song is great for it. But what I'll do is I'll start the song earlier, that way it matches up better. But for the first three episodes, which is like just the intro of the freaking game, lots of reading, putting all my Pokemon into the game, it's fine. And the fourth episode too, because I'd already recorded part of it. But after episode 4, starting with episode 5, it's going to be a different intro. Or like, it's going to, the song is going to play differently. Because there was way too much intro part with the first couple lines of the song. It didn't match up. Oh, I also finished all of my eggs for Pokemon Violet playthrough. And I've started working on Pokemon Legends Arceus, the game I have neglected for way too long. So, what I've been doing so far was, trying to complete all the Pokedex entries that I had. Aside from legendary Pokemon and Pokemon that have yet to evolve, I'm getting all the Pokemon ready to evolve. That way I can do a huge evolution thing all one after another, so I don't have to cut them all in. And then I'm going to complete all those evolutions. And whenever all of it is done, I will be back for the game. I don't know at what point I'm going to start recording it. I almost want to complete all my Pokemon games before I get Legends Arceus going again. That way it can be the sole Pokemon game and I can start working on different franchises. Because I really want to play Luigi's Mansion 2, but I want to play through Luigi's Mansion 1 first. So, like, I want to finish off Scarlet so I can start Luigi's Mansion. I want to finish off Brilliant Diamond so I can play something else. I don't know. Brilliant Diamond's gonna go for a while. I want to finish off Emerald so that I can import the Pokemon into Omega Ruby and start playing through Omega Ruby so I can continue the game. Because Emerald is gonna go for a while. This Feraligatr is real buff. I started with Chikorita, but I have the other two on my team because Chikorita is balls. At least it's balls right now. Oh, well, actually, if I can have Chikorita for Brock and Misty, then that'd be great because grass is good there. Of course, I wouldn't have it for Giovanni because Giovanni is not in this game. Crunch kills you. Flamethrower on Psyduck. I'm not really afraid of a Psyduck. Oh, and it's burned. Psychic. Okay. Oh, no. Oh, no! Oh, my God, it lived. Never mind. If Blizzard's targeted by a water move, he's dead. He lived on one health. Please don't kill me, Psyduck. Please don't kill me, Psyduck. Oh my god, it's dumb. Hurt by its burn. Boom. Boom. Blaze! Blaze has the power of Blaze. His name is his ability. Boom. Holy freaking crap. Crit psychic leaves him. I think he's got one health left. His HP bar is completely empty. Well, almost completely empty. Well, let's see how much he lived with. He lived with 5 health. Wow. Oh my god. It was a neutral hit from full frickin' health. Would you like to fight my pack of Pikachu? Originally he said my Pikachu gang. I don't want to fight you with water. Let's go you. Because, oh wait, no, I have Technician. Never mind. Let's just say I have, Limber. So I can't be paralyzed. I forgot I don't have Limber. I have Technician. That's okay. Oh boy. This is gonna take forever. Blah. I think what we'll do is we are gonna go and do the Fuchsia Gym first. Usually I like to do it in a weird, like, the order that you get there in. But we're going to do it in a weird order. Like, I could take on Sabrina, who is the strongest member. I have two fast normal-type physical attackers. The problem with Sabrina is she's also pretty strong. And if I lose Argus and Kollector, I'm screwed. So I don't want to take her on too early. I'm absolutely not taking on Lieutenant Surge right now, because I don't have a ground type. And taking on an electric leader with no ground type, it's not just super effective against electric, it's immune to electric. So you want to have at least one or two Pokemon that resist electric if you take on an electric gym leader. Otherwise, they're going to wreck you. Electricity's strong. Even though it's only good against two types. It's all those neutral hits that really hurt. Actually, if I could get a Snorlax also, that could potentially help against Lieutenant Surge. Paralyze heal. I've got water and flying. There's no freaking way I'm taking on Surge. Like, I'm better equipped to take on Sabrina because I've got a bunch of physical attackers. And then I've got like a fast Pokemon with super effective move in Crobat, but it's also weak to Psychic. Which isn't wise. So we're going to take on Janine, because poison type I can deal with, I think. Like, I don't have psychic, I don't have ground, but I have fire, and she has a lot of bug Pokemon. And then her trainers have weaknesses that I can exploit. Like, I don't have the poison weakness, but I have, like, there's, like, the Nidos, there's Vileplume. Those are weak to grass and water, so I can deal with those. The pure poison types are a problem, because, again, I don't have psychic or ground. But I think I can deal with it. Oh, wait. Magikarp is known as Carp King in Japanese. I don't know why they didn't just give him Sea King, or Kingdra, or Kingler, or Nidoqueen, or Vespaqueen. Vespaquin. You could have a level 100 Magikarp, and it would still lose, because Magikarp is weak AF. Oh no, it used Flail. What? Dead. Bored. Yeah, my Feraligatr is very strong now. Let's go Nitara. Because she was the first one I trained to level 42. But I haven't got to use her like in a regular battle yet. Tanner. Oh, come on. Really? Well, I'm not going to fight you. Go for Alligator. Now there's no debate who's the better starter. For Alligator or Typhlosion. Who cares? I have both of them. My poor Chikorita. Sit in the box, being very sad. I made a Chikorita egg in Brilliant Diamond for Violet. So hopefully we do get to see Chikorita in that game.
I mean, I might get Chikorita later. It'd be funny to challenge Red with all three Johto starters. Yo, how sick would it be if my team ended up with all three Johto starters, Crobat, Tyranitar, and Ampharos? That would be amazing. I'd be so down for that team. Though it wouldn't have a ground type for taking on his Pikachu. I'm pretty sure Tyranitar won't die from a one shot. At least I hope not. Boom! Unlike this tiny Whismur. If your opponent doesn't have a fighting type, normal type Pokemon are mean. Because you can teach them anything. I have three normal types. And they're good normal types too. Two of them serve the same purpose. Ambipom and Persian. They're both fast, heavy hitters with Technician. And then we got Snorlax, who is a slow, bulky tank. Well, we got Munchlax. We'll get Snorlax eventually. Ooh. I should go get a haircut, but I'm going to wait until I get to Fuchsia. I also need a haircut in real life, because my hair's getting long. Alright. Fly. I was gonna switch to Feraligatr, but I wanna use, Crobat. Furious swipes. Damn. Wow. Way to go, Nitara. Ah, crap. I'm out. Okay, Feraligatr, you can take that. You can take that. You can take that. God damn. Why is it always a crit? It's always a freaking crit. Every time. Every single time it's a freaking crit. With his defense, he could have taken that. Oh, great, it's a golem. And now I don't have a freaking water type. Awesome. Screech. Because I can't attack because of the choice scarf. Okay. Die, you stupid golem. Ha ha! One-shotted. How do you like it? I wasn't gonna use Fly on a Graveler. Of course he uses Self-Destruct. I hate you! And your Pokemon hate you too, because you just blew them up. Freaking hell. I have to walk all the way back. One more death, and I can transfer these guys to the next game. Which ones are they? And can they all go into Violet? Yeah. As of right now, all of these Pokemon can go into Violet. That's pretty good. Make sure I take that off. Okay. I lost my Pokemon to the absolute cheapest ways. Well, except for Jumpluff. Jumpluff, I should have switched. A freaking counter, self-destruct, I got 5. This is like the third time I got number 5. Misdreavus, ooh, ghost type, sweet. If I see which way the wind is blowing, I'll switch to Ermac so that he can take a self-destruct or explosion. And then, he'll just pass through him and he'll get all the experience. Alright. I should train up Ermac because I would want the type. Actually, you know what? Now that I think about it, Sabrina might be the perfect choice now. I'm definitely going to need to train up Ermac before I take her on. But I think I'm going to do Janine first. Because... I'm going to do Janine first because she's the lowest level gym leader. But with the types I have right now, 3 normal types, and then 1 ghost type that isn't weak to psychic... It might actually be a really good idea to go for Sabrina. We'll go Janine first, and then we'll go Sabrina. And then we'll go Erica. Because, we got a poison type, we got a fire type, and a flying type. Yeah. We'll do those 3 first. 5, 6, and 4. And then I'm screwed because I can't go for Blaine or Blue because I need to get to Cinnabar in order to get Blue, and then I need Surf to get to where Blaine is. And then Lieutenant Surge requires at least a ground type. Misty requires at least an electric or grass type. And Brock requires a grass or electric type. So I don't know what I'm going to do. But at least we've got 3 gym leaders that should be somewhat handleable. Agility, whatever. These trainers are no joke. And they're weaker than me, and they keep killing me. Very annoying. I think I'm going to go to 30... Whenever Ermac lands Shadow Ball... Unless I have Shadow Ball, then I can just... No, I don't have Shadow Ball, never mind. I give it to Espeon. As soon as he learns Shadow Ball... I will evolve him into Miss Magius. I think that's at like 43 or something. Hello. Good for you. I also want to get to Powell Park so that I can, if I want to transfer Pokemon, I can transfer Pokemon in this game. I'm using the other one. Good. Way to go, Nitara. Where did I mint this side? I don't care. I'm salty. I lost my freaking Feraligatr to Explosion or Self-Destruct. They're the same move. I'm so glad they made them weak in future generations. They're not weak by much. Up until, I think, Generation 6 or 7, Explosion and Self-Destruct had a hidden thing that they did. It would sharply reduce your defense before the attack. Like, it wouldn't say that, but it would do even more damage than normal. So, if that's why, if you take massive damage from Explosion, that's why. Because it was doing that increased damage.